Hi everyone. We are starting the series of seminars organized by the Bank of Ceylon under the Nanajaya program. First of all, I'm thanking to the Bank of Ceylon for giving me this great opportunity. So today my discussion is focused on the second and third lessons of the syllabus. The second lesson is market demand, supply, elasticity and the market equilibrium analyzing. And then the third lesson is government intervention to the market operations. So this discussion is based on these two lessons. As we are aware, these two lessons are very important lessons to the whole paper. From MCQ paper, it covers about 10 MCQs from the 50 MCQs. And two full structured questions will be given from these two lessons. So this discussion is based on a question series of MCQs. So we will start the discussion. So we will see the first question. All of the following factors create a rightward shift of the demand curve of a normal good traded in a competitive market, except. So we are learning the two concepts, the change in demand and then the change in quantity demand. The change in quantity demand refers to a movement along the demand curve. A change in quantity demand occurs because of a change in the price of the good being considered while all the other factors are held constant. But then what do we mean by a change in demand? A change in demand refers to a shift of the whole demand curve. A change in demand occurs because of a change in any other demand determinant other than the price of the good being considered. And then a change in demand will lead for a shift of the whole demand curve, maybe a rightward shift of the demand curve or else a leftward shift of the demand curve. So in this question, they want us to identify the factor which is not creating a rightward shift of the demand curve. The factor which is not creating a rightward shift of the demand curve. Right? We will analyze one by one the given answers. Answer number one, increase in the consumer income. Increase in the consumer income will lead for a rightward shift of the demand curve if the good being considered is a normal good. How do we define a normal good? A normal good is defined as a good having a positive relationship between the income and the demand. So if the good being considered is a normal good, when the consumer income increases, the demand for that respective good goes up and create a rightward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. Therefore, increasing the consumer income will lead for a rightward shift of the demand curve. Second point, decreasing the price of a complementary good. What do we mean by a complementary good? A complementary good refers to a good, right, which should be used together with the good being considered to get a certain satisfaction. We know that in order to operate an operate a fan, we need electricity. So in that case, electricity and a fan are two complementary goods to each other. So when the price of a complementary good increases, what happens is the cost of consumption of the good being considered goes up. And therefore, the demand of the good being considered will go down. So this answer says decrease in the price of a complementary good. If the price of a complementary good decreased, what happens is the cost of consumption of the good being considered goes down. So the consumer will increase the demand for that good. For an example, if the price of electricity goes down, the cost of consumption of electronic appliances will go down. So that will lead for increase in the demand for electronic equipment. So therefore, decrease in the price of a complementary good will lead for an increase in the demand of the good being considered. So that will also create a rightward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. So therefore, again, this question wants us to identify a factor which does not create a rightward shift of the demand curve. So the first answer, the second answer, both of them are creating a rightward shift of the demand curve. Third one, expecting a future price increase of the good. So, if the consumer thinks that the price of this product will go up in the future, right? He won't wait until the price of the product goes down. Sorry, price of the product goes up. If the consumer expects that the price of this product will go up in the future, he will now go to the market and buy the product being considered. Right? So the current demand increases if the consumer thinks that the price of this product will go up in the future. So therefore, the third answer, expecting a future price increase of the good, will also lead for a rightward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. The fourth answer, decrease in the price of the good being considered. Decrease in the price of the good being considered. As I told you, if the price of the good being considered changes, that only leads for a change in quantity demanded of the good being considered. What do we mean by a change in the quantity demanded of the good being considered? Now, for an example, we will say, previously the price of the good being considered was 60 rupees, and under the price of 60 rupees, consumer was demanding some 200 units from this respective product being considered. Right? So, if the price of this product goes down from maybe 60 to 40 rupees. This might be leading for the quantity demanded of the product being considered to increase from 200 to 250 units. So therefore, if the price of the good being considered goes down, that is only leading for an increase in the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So what do we mean by an increase in the quantity demanded? An increase in the quantity demanded is only leading for a movement along the demand curve from one point to another point. Right? So therefore, if the price of the good being considered changes, that never leads for a shift of the demand curve, and that is only leading for a movement along the demand curve. So, if the price of the good being considered decreases, the quantity demanded of the good being considered goes up. To the other way, if the price of the good being considered increases, the quantity demanded of the good being considered goes down. So, therefore, if the price of the good being considered is changing, that is only leading for a movement along the demand curve from one point to another point on the demand curve, and that is not leading for a shift of the demand curve. So therefore, the fourth answer, decrease in the price of the good being considered, is only leading for a movement along the demand curve, and that is not leading for a shift of the demand curve. So again, in the question, what they want us is, all of the following factors create a rightward shift of the demand curve of a normal good trader in a competitive market, except. So what they want is a factor which is not leading for a rightward shift of the demand curve. So the fourth answer is just leading for a movement from one point to another point along the demand curve, and that does not create a rightward shift of the demand curve. So therefore, the answer should be the fourth answer. Right, the fourth answer only leads for if the price of the good being considered decreases, the quantity demanded of the good being considered is going up. So therefore, that is not leading for a rightward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. And then, if so, therefore, the answer should be the fourth answer. But if you see the fifth answer also, what does the fifth answer say? Increase in the price of substitute goods. What do we mean by a substitute good? A substitute good is a good which can be used instead of the good being considered. A substitute good is a good which can be used instead of the good being considered to get a certain satisfaction. For an example, in order to fulfill our hunger, we may use bread, or maybe we are using rice as well. So therefore, rice and bread are two substitutes to each other. So if price of rice increases, that will lead for an increase in the demand for bread, and therefore demand curve for bread will be shifted to the right. To the other way, if price of rice decreases, what happens is the bread consumers will shift their consumption from bread to rice, and therefore the demand for bread will go down. So therefore, change in the price of a substitute is leading for a shift of the demand curve. And here it says increase in the price of substitute goods. When the price of a substitute good increases, what happens is the consumers of that respective substitutes will shift their consumption to the good being considered, and therefore the demand of the good being considered will increase and will create a rightward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. So out of these five answers, the first answer, second answer, third answer, and the fifth answer, all four answers are creating a rightward shift of the demand curve. But the fourth answer, decrease in the price of the good being considered, is only leading for a downward movement along the demand curve, which is identified as an increase in the quantity demanded. So the answer for the first question should be the fourth answer. Right. So we will move on to the next question. Right, we will see. So through this question, what I am expecting is when the demand curve is given, how to develop the demand equation. When the demand equation is given, how to develop the demand equation of that respective demand curve. We know that the standard form of the demand equation is right. The standard form of the demand equation is QD equals to A minus BP. QD equals to A minus BP is the standard form of the demand equation. QD is standing for quantity demanded. A is standing for quantity demanded when price is zero, and then B is standing for the slope of the demand curve, and then P is standing for the price of the good being considered. So when the demand schedule is given for the product being considered, the best option is to develop a small schedule based on that. Now you can see there are two prices available in this demand curve. When the price is rupees 60, the quantity demanded is 120 units, and when the price is rupees 80, the quantity demanded is 0 units. Right? Again, when the price is rupees 60, the quantity demanded is 120 units, and then when the price is 80, the quantity demanded is 0 units. Right? So based on that, we can develop a schedule. How? When the price is rupees 60, the corresponding quantity demanded is 120 units. And when the price is rupees 80, the quantity demanded is 0. So the first step is to calculate the slope of the demand curve. The slope is delta QD divided by delta P. When price increases from 60 to 80 by 20 rupees, the quantity demanded decreases by 120, from 120 units to 0 units. So therefore, change in quantity demanded is 120, and then change in price is 20. Therefore, the slope of the demand curve is 6. Right? The slope of this demand curve is 6. The next step is to calculate the value of A. Right? Again, the standard form of the demand equation is QD equals to A minus BP. Right? We already calculated the slope of the demand curve, and the slope is 6. Afterwards, what we should do, we have two coordinates. When price is 60, the quantity demanded is 120 units. And when price is rupees 80, the quantity demanded is 0 units. You can choose any of these two coordinates, right? So if you use 60 as the price, the corresponding quantity demanded is 120 units. So if you apply 60 for the price, you need to say 124 the quantity demanded. So by simplifying this equation, you can get the value of A. So according to this calculation, the value of A is 480 units. So we found out the value of A, we found out the slope of the demand curve. Then what we should do is to state the equation. QD equals to 480 minus 60. Right? So we developed a small schedule, and then based on that we calculated the slope of the demand curve. And then afterwards we calculated the value of A. Afterwards you can state the demand equation. So this is how we should develop the demand equation for the product being considered when the demand curve is given. Right. So therefore, out of these five answers, the answer that we calculated and obtained was QD equals to 480 minus 6P. QD equals to 480 minus 6P. So this is the equation, the corresponding demand equation for this respective graph. Right. So we will move on to the third question. Right, PVC. Electricity is a complementary good for electric kettles. Therefore, if price of electricity increases, I was discussing about complementary goods in the first MCQ question as well. What do we mean by a complementary good? A complementary good is a good which should be used along with the good being considered to get a certain satisfaction. As I told you, you have to have electricity to use electronic appliances. And then in order to use a mobile phone, you need to have a mobile connection. And then in order to use a vehicle, you have to have some kind of a fuel. So therefore, a good which should be used together with the good being considered is what we identify as a complementary good. So now, what does this question say? Electricity is a complementary good for electric kettles, right? And then, if the price of electricity increases, what happens? If the price of electricity increases, the cost of consumption of electric kettles will go up, no? Because electricity is a complementary good for electric kettles. Then what happens? If the price of electricity increases, the cost of consumption of electric kettles go up, and then as a result, the demand for electric kettles will go down. As a result, the demand for electric kettles will go down. As I told you, in the first MCQ we discussed, except for price, if any other demand determinant changes, that will lead for a shift of the whole demand curve. Right? It may be a rightward shift of the demand curve, or else it can be a leftward shift of the demand curve as well. So therefore, again, if price of electricity increases, that will lead for demand for electric kettles to go down. We will try to explain this with a diagram as well. So in the first diagram, I will show you the demand curve for electricity. So if price of electricity increases, say the price of electricity increases from P1 to P2, that leads for the quantity demanded for electricity to go down from Q1 to Q2. If price of electricity increases, that leads for quantity demanded of electricity to go down. And that is just leading for a downward movement along the demand curve from A to B. That is leading for a downward movement along the demand curve of electricity right from A to B. But then electric kettles, we will draw the demand curve for electric kettles. As we discussed, electric kettles is a complementary good for the electricity. So when the price of electricity increases, what happens is, the demand for electric kettles will go down. The demand for electric kettles will go down. So therefore, with these two diagrams, you should be able to clearly understand the difference between the change in quantity demanded and the change in demand, right? So if price of electricity increases from P1 to P2, that leads for the quantity demanded of electricity to go down from Q1 to Q2, right? And that is just a movement along the demand curve. But then when the price of electricity increases, as electricity is a complementary good to the electric kettles, what will happen to the demand for electric kettles? The demand for electric kettles will go down, leading for a leftward shift of the demand curve for electric kettles. So again, the result of this is the quantity demanded for electric kettles go down, and then quantity demanded for electricity decreases, and then the demand for electric kettles go down. We will move to the question. We will analyze the five answers. The demand for electric kettles increases, wrong, by here the reduction increase in the prices of electricity and not of electric kettles, right? So therefore, as the price of electricity increases, that affects on quantity demanded of electricity and nothing else. We cannot say the demand for electric kettles increases for the demand for electric kettles to PVC. Here the electricity is a complementary good for electric kettles. So if the price of electricity increases, what happens is the cost of consumption of electricity increases, and therefore demand for electric kettles will go down. But the first answer says demand for electric kettles increases, therefore it is a wrong answer. And then the second answer, demand for electricity decreases, right? The price of electricity increases, the quantity demanded for electricity will go down, not the demand for electricity. Third answer, the quantity demanded for electric kettles decreases, that is also wrong. Why is it? The price of electricity only changes, not the price of electric kettles. The fourth answer, the price of electric kettles increases. No, again, the question is talking about the price of electricity. The price of electricity is affecting on the demand for electric kettles. The last answer, we actually showed it through the diagram. When the price of electricity increases from P1 to P2, the demand for electric kettles decreases, creating a leftward shift of the demand curve for electric kettles. So therefore, with these five answers, we should understand that the fifth answer is the correct answer. The demand for electric kettles go down. So it should be the fifth answer for the third question. Electricity is a complementary good for electric kettles. Therefore, if price of electricity increases, that leads for the demand for electric kettles to go down, and therefore it will create a leftward shift of the demand curve for electric kettles. Right, we will move on to the next. Right, we will See the question. Following demand curve is related to an inferior good. Following demand curve is related to an inferior good. So we will do a little discussion regarding the inferior goods. What do we mean by an inferior good? An inferior good refers to a good having a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. An inferior good is a good which is having a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. When the consumer income increases, the demand for inferior goods will go down. And then when the consumer income decreases, the demand for inferior goods will go up. If we go to the law of demand represents a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. Right? The law of demand states that there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. According to the law of demand, when price of the good being considered increases, the quantity demanded of that good will go down. Also, when the price of the good being considered decreases, the quantity demanded of that good will go up. There is such a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. Two reasons are affecting on this negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. The two reasons for the law of demand are, one is the substitution effect, the other one is the income effect. We will have a brief explanation, a discussion on the substitution effect of a price change and then the income effect of a price change. What does the substitution effect state? When the price of the good being considered increases while the other factors are held constant, the good being considered becomes relatively expensive over the other substitutes. For an example, when all other factors are held constant, if price of rice increased, what happens is, when all other factors are held constant, if price of rice increased, what happens is, rice becomes relatively expensive over the other substitutes for rice. Right? Bread, string hoppers, and all other food items are substitutes for rice. So if price of rice increased, what happens is, rice becomes relatively expensive over the other substitutes. What happens? The rice consumers will shift their consumption from rice to the other relatively cheaper substitutes. That will lead for the quantity demanded of rice to go down. Right? So price of rice increases, rice becomes relatively expensive over the other substitutes. And therefore, the rice consumers are shifting their consumption to the relatively cheaper substitutes, and that is why the quantity demanded of good being considered goes down. To the other way, when the price of the good being considered decreases while the other factors are held constant, the good being considered becomes relatively cheaper over the other substitutes. The consumers of the other substitutes will shift their consumption from those to the good being considered. And that will lead for the quantity demanded of the good being considered to go up. That will lead for the quantity demanded of the good being considered to go up. This is how we can explain the substitution effect, which is one reason for the law of demand. Right? Very carefully get this application. Always the substitution effect is supporting to the law of demand. That is, the substitution effect is always supporting to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. But then, what do we mean by the income effect of a price change? When the price of the good being considered increases, when the price of the good being considered increases, the real income of the consumer, What do we mean by the real income? The real income refers to the purchasing power of the money income, the amount of goods which could be purchased by using a given amount of money is what we identify as the real income. So when the price of the good being considered increases, while the other factors are held constant, the real income of the consumer, that is, in other words, the purchasing power of the money income of the consumer, decreases. This is why the quantity demanded of the good being considered goes down. To the other way, if the price of the good being considered decreases while the other factors are held constant, that leads for the real income of the consumer to go up. What does this mean? When the price of the good being considered decreases while the other factors are held constant, the amount of goods the consumer can purchase by using a given amount of money goes up. The amount of the good being considered which can be purchased by using a given amount of money goes up. As a result, the quantity demanded of the good being considered is going up. Right? So these are the two reasons for the law of demand. When the good being considered is a normal good, both the substitution effect as well as the income effect are supporting to this negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. When the good being considered is a normal good, both the substitution effect as well as the income effect are supporting to the law of demand. That is, essentially, there will be a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. If the good being considered is a normal good, the substitution effect supports the law of demand, the income effect supports the law of demand. So therefore, definitely, there will be a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. But the thing is, the question is identifying the good being considered as an inferior good. The good being considered is identified as an inferior good. The income effect supports the law of demand. The income effect supposed to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good only if the good being considered is a normal good. When the good being considered is an inferior good, right? When the good being considered is an inferior good, the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. The substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded, whereas the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So, therefore, the ultimate relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered decides upon the size of the substitution effect and then the size of the income effect. At a situation where the good being considered is an inferior good, right? When the good being considered is an inferior good, the substitution effect supports the law of demand, but the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good, right? So at such a situation, the ultimate relationship, the final relationship which is there between the price of the good being considered and the quantity demanded of the good being considered decides upon the size of the substitution effect and then the size of the income effect. The relative size of the substitution effect and then the relative size of the income effect. Right? So, when the good being considered is an inferior good, The substitution effect supports the law of demand, and then the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. At such a situation, if substitution effect is more powerful than the income effect, the substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded, but the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. But if the substitution effect is more stronger, the substitution effect is still powerful, and therefore the price and the quantity demanded will be negatively related. Price and the quantity demanded will be negatively related. But when the good being considered is an inferior good and the income effect is more stronger than the substitution effect, when the good being considered is an inferior good and if the income effect is more stronger than the substitution effect, what happens? If the income effect is more stronger, the income effect is going against the law of demand there, and it is more stronger than the substitution effect. What happens is that overrules the law of demand and creates a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. Such an inferior good is what we identify as a given good. Such an inferior good only we identify as a given good. Right? But then, in this question, the demand curve of an inferior good is given. But then you can see this demand curve is sloping downwards. This demand curve is sloping downwards. So the demand curve is sloping downwards means what? When price increases, the quantity demanded goes down. So even if the question says that this is an inferior good, still the demand curve is sloping downwards. What does it mean? Still there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. There is still a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So therefore, even the question says that it is an inferior good, it is not a given good. Why is it? There is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. If it is an inferior good, if the good being considered is a given good, there should be a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. That is, that graph should slope upwards. But here, in this question, the given demand curve is sloping downwards. The given demand curve is sloping downwards. The demand curve is sloping downwards means what? There is still a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So therefore, even though the good being considered is an inferior good here, it is not a given good. It is not a given good. If it is a given good, there should be a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded like this. But here, the given graph is sloping downwards. That is, the demand curve of this respective good is sloping downwards, showing a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So therefore, this is an inferior good, as the question says, but it is not a given good. This does not behave according to the law of demand. That is wrong. Why? The demand curve slopes downwards. There is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. Therefore, it works according to the law of demand. Second one, even though it is an inferior good, yes, the question says so, it is not a given good. Exactly, yes. It is an inferior good. Why? How? The question says so. But it is not a given good. Why is it? If it is a given good, there should be a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. There should be a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. In that case, that graph should slope upwards. So therefore, the answer for this question should be the second answer. Even though it is an inferior good, it is not a given good. We will see the other answers too. This is an inferior good as well as a given good. No, why? If it is a given good, the graph should slope upwards, showing a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. The fourth answer, both substitution effect as well as the income effect of this good supports the law of demand. No, why? I explained at the beginning. Whenever the good being considered is an inferior good, the income effect does not support to the law of demand. Only the substitution effect is supporting to the law of demand there. So therefore, the fourth answer is also wrong, which is saying that the substitution effect as well as the income effect are supporting to the law of demand. Answer number 5, when price of this good increases, its quantity demanded also goes up, is wrong. Why? If when price increases, if quantity demanded is also going up, as I told you, that demand curve should slope upwards like this. It doesn't happen. So therefore, the answer number 2 is the correct answer for this. Even though it is an inferior good, it is not a given good. Thank you. Right, we will move on to the next question. The demand equation of a certain good is given below. QD equals to 240 minus 10P. The value of coefficient of price elasticity of demand at the price of rupees 50. This question is identifying the way of calculating the price elasticity of demand at a certain price when the demand equation is given. Right, again we are aware of the standard form of the demand equation. Standard form of the demand equation is QD equals to A minus BP. Right, here the B is standing for what? The slope of the demand curve, which is calculated by using the formula delta QD divided by delta P. Change in quantity demanded divided by change in price is the way we are calculating the slope of the demand curve. In this, the demand the B is standing for the slope of the demand curve. And then the price elasticity of demand, right? Price elasticity of demand measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded of the good being considered to a certain percentage change in the price of the good being considered. The point price elasticity of demand is calculated by using the formula change in quantity demanded divided by change in price multiplied by P over QD ratio. This is how we are calculating the price elasticity of demand at a specific price. As I already showed here, the delta QD over delta P ratio is standing for the slope of the demand curve. The slope of the demand curve can be represented through symbol B. So this equation can be restated as B into P over QD as well. This equation can be restated as B into P over QD as well. Right? So we are given the demand equation of this product as QD equals to 240 minus 10P. And we are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at the price of rupees 50. We will see. QD equals to 240 minus 10p. And we are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at rupees 15, no? Right, we are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at rupees 15. So therefore, we should apply that price of rupees 15 and calculate the corresponding quantity demanded at the price of rupees 15. 240 minus 10 times 15 is 150. So the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 15 is 90 units. Quantity demanded at the price of rupees 15 is how much? 90 units. Right. And then the equation for point price elasticity of demand is delta QD divided by delta P multiplied by P over QD. And then the delta QD over delta P is standing for the slope of the demand curve, which is B. So B into P over QD. Right. By looking at the demand equation, we can directly extract the slope, which is 10. So we are supposed to calculate price elasticity of demand at rupees 15. The slope is 10. Price is rupees 15. We already calculated that the quantity demanded at this price is 90 units. When you set these two off, 15 divided by 9 is, we are showing price elasticity of demand should be minus always, minus 1.66. So therefore, price elasticity of demand at rupees 15 is minus 1.66. We will go back to the given answers. Plus 1.66 is given as the first answer. Second is plus 0.75. But the third answer is giving the correct answer as we showed in the previous calculation. It is minus 1.66. So therefore, price elasticity of demand at rupees 15 is how much? Is minus 1.66. Right, we will move on to the question number 6. Right, we will see. The demand equation of a certain good traded in a competitive market is given by QD equals to 250 minus 10p. Price elasticity of demand within the price range of rupees 15 and rupees 20. I will go back to the fifth question to see this difference between the fifth question and the sixth question. So if you go back to the fifth question, here we are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at rupees 15 at a specific price. We are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at rupees 15. So when we are supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at a specific price, we need to be aware that the question is talking about point price elasticity of demand. So we use the formula delta QD divided by delta P multiplied by P over QD to calculate the point price elasticity of demand. But when it comes to the question number 6, the question is slightly different from the previous question. See? The demand equation of a certain good traded in a competitive market is given by QD equals to 250 minus 10p. Price elasticity of demand within the price range of rupees 15 and rupees 20. Previously, we were supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand at rupees 15. But here, within the price range of 15 and rupees 20. So we are here supposed to calculate the price elasticity of demand within a price range, a given price range. What does it mean? The question is talking about the arc elasticity of demand. We are supposed to calculate the arc price elasticity of demand within the price range of 15 to 20. So you should use the demand equation, and as the first step, you should calculate the quantity demanded at each price, at rupees 15 and at rupees 20 PVC. Demand equation is QD equals to 250 minus 10P. First of all, we will calculate the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 15. So, quantity demanded at rupees 15 is 100 units. Also, we'll use the same equation and calculate the quantity demanded at the next price of rupees 20. So we calculated the price, we calculated the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 15. It was 100 units, and then we calculated the quantity demanded at 20 rupees, and it was 50 units. Right. We'll now calculate the arc elasticity of demand within the range from 15 to 20 rupees. Arc elasticity of demand is calculated by using the formula change in quantity demanded divided by change in price multiplied by the two prices are in the numerator P1 plus P2. And in the denominator, it should be Q1 plus Q2. Right, PVC. The delta QD over delta P is standing for the slope. You can directly extract it from the demand equation, which is minus 10. As the demand equation is there with us, we can directly extract the slope of the demand equation. Or else, here you have two prices and two quantities are also available. So, if I so at the price of rupees 15, quantity demanded is 100 units. At the price of rupees 20, quantity demanded is 50 units. Quantity demanded is 50 units. So this slope, instead of directly extracting it from the demand equation, you can calculate it by using this schedule as well. We will do that as well. So change in quantity, change in price is 5 here, and the change in quantity is 50 here. Delta QD 50, delta P 5. So the slope of the demand curve is 10. So in this kind of a situation where you have the demand schedule, either by directly extracting from the equation or else by using the schedule also, you can do the calculation. So we will use the demand equation to get the slope. N, the two prices are first price rupees 15, second price rupees 20. Quantities, quantity demanded at rupees 15 is 100 units, quantity demanded at rupees 20 is 50 units. So thirty-five divided by fifteen, 2.33. So you will get the answer for price elasticity of demand within the price range from 15 to 20 as -2.33. As there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good, the price elasticity of demand is always minus. That is to represent that there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. But when we are interpreting the price elasticity of demand, we ignore this sign and just take the value. But whenever we are presenting the price elasticity of demand, we present it with the minus sign to say that there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good. So we'll go back to the question. Price elasticity of demand within the price range of rupees 15 and 20 is 2.33 and it is minus. So it should be the first answer for this question. It should be answer number 1. Price elasticity of demand within this range is 15 to 20 rupees is -2.33. Right. We'll move on to the question number 7. Question number 7. Demand schedule of a unitary elastic demand curve is given below. Right. Based on the value what we get for price elasticity of demand, we categorize price elasticity of demand into 5 categories. Right? From them, what do we mean by unitary elastic price elasticity of demand? Unitary elastic price elasticity of demand refers to a situation where the percentage change in the quantity demanded is exactly equal to the percentage change in the price. Is what we identify as unitary elastic price elasticity of demand. The price elasticity of demand is 1 under a unitary elastic price elasticity of demand. And then there is a specific demand curve when the price elasticity of demand is unitary elastic. The demand curve is taking the shape of a rectangular hyperbola. When the price elasticity of demand is unitary elastic, right? This is a specific shaped demand curve, right? The standard demand equation of QD equals to A minus BP won't work here, and then we will not be able to identify a linear relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. That is, you can't say for every price increase of 10 rupees, the quantity demanded decreases by some specific quantity. Right? So the standard form of QD equals to A minus BP will not be applied to a demand curve like this, which is identified as a rectangular hyperbola. So therefore, in this question, if you go back to the question, what do they ask us to do? So they have given us two prices and then the corresponding quantities. According to the above schedule, the quantity demanded at price rupees 40. Right? We cannot think in this way. 10, 20, 30, 40, and then QD should go down from 1600 to 600 by 600 units, and in the next stage it should go down by another 600 units. No, why? There is no a linear relationship between the price and the quantity demanded under a unitary elastic demand curve. The reason is the demand curve is taking the shape of a rectangular hyperbola like this. The demand curve is taking the shape of a rectangular hyperbola like this. So therefore, we are unable to use the demand equation and get into the answer for this. Right? Why is it? The demand is a unitary elastic. Here the demand curve is a unitary elastic demand curve. Here the demand curve is a unitary elastic demand curve. That is, it is a rectangular hyperbola. Right. When the price elasticity of demand is unitary elastic, we identify a specific relationship between the price and the change in price and the change in consumer expenditure. When the product being considered is having a unitary elastic price elasticity of demand, the consumer expenditure, what do we mean by the consumer expenditure? If 1200 units are bought at 10 rupees each, the consumer should spend 10 into 1200, 12,000 rupees. Like this, the total amount of money the consumer should spend in order to buy a certain quantity at a certain price. Right? The total amount of money the consumer should spend in order to buy a certain quantity at a certain price is what we identify as the consumer expenditure. When the product being considered is having a unitary elastic price elasticity of demand, the consumer expenditure does not change. The consumer expenditure does not change even when the price of the product changes. The consumer expenditure everywhere on that demand curve is same. That is, when you multiply price by quantity, the answer what you get is same everywhere on that demand curve. So that is the only thing that you can use here to arrive at the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 40. Now for an example here, when the price is rupees 10, the consumer is buying 1200 units, so the consumer expenditure at this point is 12,000 rupees. Why is it 1200 units are bought at the price of rupees 10? And at the price of rupees 20, the consumer is buying how much? 600 units. So see, 20 times 600 is how much? 12,000 rupees. So as I told you, if the product being considered is having a unitary elastic price elasticity of demand, the consumer expenditure does not change when price changes from one price to another price. At rupees 10, the consumer expenditure is 12,000, and at rupees 20, the consumer expenditure is 12,000 rupees. The consumer expenditure does not change when price changes. So that relationship we will see. When the price is rupees 10, quantity demanded is 1200 units. So the consumer expenditure is 12,000 rupees. Also, when the price is rupees 20, the given quantity demanded is 600 units, right? So the consumer expenditure is 12,000 rupees. What they want us here in this question is to calculate the quantity demanded when the price is rupees 40. We'll go back to the question. Right? According to the above schedule, the quantity demanded at price rupees 40 is, we are supposed to get the quantity demanded at the price of rupees, how much? 40. Right, at the quantity of 40, we need to find out the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 40, PVC. So, whatever the quantity the consumers are willing to buy at the price of rupees 40, we need to know one thing. What is it? The consumer expenditure should be 12,000 rupees. We learned that. If the product being considered is having a unitary elastic demand, right, the consumer expenditure does not change when price changes, right? So even at rupees 40, whatever the quantity demanded is, the consumer's expenditure should be 12,000 rupees. So therefore, we can divide 12,000 by 40. So the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 40 is 300 units. Quantity demanded at the price of rupees 40 is 300 units. This is how you should calculate the quantity demanded. We are unable to use the standard form of the demand equation again here. Why is it? The demand is a unitary elastic demand curve. When the demand is unitary elastic, the demand curve is taking the shape of a rectangular hyperbola. So therefore, the answer for this question should be 300 units. Answer for this question should be 300 units. The quantity demanded when the price is rupees 40, the corresponding quantity demanded is 300 units. Right. We'll move on to the next question. Question number 8. When the price of a certain good is rupees 150, its quantity demanded is 500 units. Price elasticity of demand at this price is minus 4.5. By how much the producer revenue changes if the price of this product decreased by 50 rupees? Right. Again, we will have to calculate this based on the given information. Right. First of all, we'll write down the given information in a small schedule, PVC. Right. Price quantity demanded, and they've given us the price elasticity of demand as well. Right. We'll go back to the question. When price is rupees 150, quantity demanded is 500 units. Price elasticity of demand at this price is 4.5. Previously. Price 150. Quantity demanded is 500 units. Price elasticity of demand at this point is 4.5. But what they want us to find out is the price. If the price decreased by 50 rupees, they want us to know by how much the producer revenue changes. Producer revenue is another way of identifying the consumer expenditure. When consumers spend some amount and purchase some quantity, right, that expenditure incurred by the consumer from producer's point of view, it is his revenue. The expenditure incurred by the consumer from his point of view is the revenue from producer's point of view. Right, PVC. Right, if price decreased by rupees 50, how much should be the new price? Should be rupees 100. If price decreases from rupees 150 to 100 rupees, 150 rupees by 50 rupees, the new quantity, new price should be rupees 100. Right. We don't know the quantity demanded at the new price, but as I already told you, the producer revenue should be calculated. Producer revenue should be calculated by multiplying the price by the quantity. So when the price is rupees 150, the quantity demanded is 500 units. So the consumer expenditure, or in other words, the producer revenue is 75,000 rupees. 75,000 rupees, right? But what they want us to find out is by how much the producer revenue changes. By how much the producer revenue changes as a result of decrease in the price. So in order to find out this answer, we need to know the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 100. We need to know the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 100, and based on that, the revenue gained by the producer. Based on that, the revenue gained by the producer. Right. We will have to go to the equation for price elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand is delta QD divided by delta P multiplied by P over QD. The price elasticity of demand at this price is given as 4.5. So we can apply the figure. In this kind of a calculation, you can ignore the negative sign and do the calculation. With the negative sign, what we need to know is there is a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. That is, if price increased, quantity demanded should go down. And if price decreased, the quantity demanded should go up. So, change in quantity demanded is not known. But change in price is how much? 50 rupees. Change in price is how much? 50 rupees. Price is rupees 150. Quantity demanded is 500 units. Price is rupees 150. Quantity demanded is 500 units. We will simplify. 1, 3. So we will do a cross multiplication. 4.5 multiplied by 3 over, it should be 500 over 3 is equal to the change in quantity demand. So when you simplify this, change in quantity demanded equals to 750 units. Change in quantity demanded is equal to 750 units. Delta QD is what 750 units is. That is, if price decreases from 150 to 100, the quantity demanded should change. That is, if price decreases, the quantity demanded should increase by 750 units. Right? When price decreases, the quantity demanded increases, no? Right? The delta QD is 750 units. What does this mean? When price of the product being considered decreases, the quantity demanded should increase by 750 units. Therefore, the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 100 is 500 plus 750, 1250. Right? 1250 is the quantity demanded at the price of rupees 100. So 100 times 1250, the producer revenue is how much? 125,000 rupees. 125,000 rupees. So producer revenue increases from 75,000 to 125,000 rupees by 50,000 rupees. Producer revenue increases by 50,000 rupees. We'll go back to the question. When the price of a certain good is rupees 150, its quantity demanded is 500 units. Price elasticity of demand at this price is 4.5. By how much the producer revenue changes if the price of this product decreased by 50 rupees? So we calculated it and we identified that the producer revenue increases by 50,000 rupees. So the answer, producer revenue increases by 50,000 rupees. Increases by 50,000 rupees. Answer number 5 is the answer for question number 8. We'll move on to the next question. Question number 9. When the consumer income increases by 25%, the demand for good X increased by 40%, while the demand for good Y decreased by 20%. What can be concluded based on the above information? Right? The consumer income increases by 25%. Right? Consumer income increases by 25%. The demand for good X increased by 40%. When consumer income increases, if the demand for the good being considered goes up, what does it mean? The good being considered is a normal good. When we are doing the previous discussion, we learned that if there is a positive relationship between the consumer income and the demand, we identify that good as a normal good. So see, when the consumer income increases by 25%, the demand for good X increased by 40%. Consumer income increases, demand increases. There is a positive relationship between the consumer income and the demand. So if there is a positive relationship between the consumer income and the demand, we should identify that good as a normal good. So therefore, good X is a normal good. Why? Consumer income and the demand are changing to the same direction. Next one. But at the time of increasing the consumer income by 25%, what happens to the quantity demanded for good Y? It goes down by 20%. When consumer income increases, the demand for Y goes down. there is a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. There is a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. If there is a negative relationship between the consumer income and demand, we should identify that as an inferior good. We should identify that as an inferior good. So we will see this. First answer, X and Y are two substitutes to each other. We cannot identify whether the two goods being considered are substitutes or not based on the relationship between income and demand. Second one, X is a complementary good to good for the good Y. Again, by looking at the relationship between the consumer income and demand, by looking at the relationship between consumer and income and demand, we cannot say whether the goods are substitutes or complementaries. Third one, X and Y are normal goods. Again, wrong. Why? When the consumer income increases, the demand for good X goes up. So it is a normal good. Correct. But when the consumer income increases by 25%, the demand for Y goes down by 20%. There is a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. Therefore, it is not a normal good, but it is an inferior good. Question number 4. X is a normal good. Yes, Y. Sorry, the answer. X is a normal good. Y, consumer income increase, demand increase. So it is a normal good. While Y is an inferior good. True. Why? Consumer income increases by 25%. Demand for good Y decreases by 20%. Here the percentages are actually not material. The direction only is material. When the consumer income increases, if demand goes up, it is a normal good. And when the consumer income increases, if demand goes down, it is an inferior good. So, when there is such a positive relationship between income and demand, it is a normal good. And when there is a negative relationship between income and demand, it is an inferior good. So, therefore, answer number 4 is the answer for the question number 9. X is a normal good while Y is an inferior good. Right, we will move on to the next. Question number 10. Suppose that bread is a normal good traded in a competitive market. How do you identify the effect of a simultaneous increase in the cost of production of bread and the consumer income on the equilibrium price and the equilibrium quantity of bread? So need to know that in the first part of the question, how do you identify the effect of a simultaneous increase in the cost of production? We need to know when say cost of production is a supply determinant. Cost of production is a supply determinant. So if cost of production increases, the supply of the product goes down. If the cost of production increases, the profitability of that product goes down and therefore supply decreases. But to the other way, if cost of production decreases, the profitability goes up and therefore supply increases. Right? And then the next one, cost of production of bread and the consumer income. On the top of the question, it says that the bread is a normal good. We already learned that if the good being considered is a normal good, there is a positive relationship between the consumer income and the demand. If the good being considered is a normal good, there is a positive relationship between the income and the demand. And in the question, it says that the consumer income changes. The consumer income is a demand determinant. Right. So, cost of production increases is leading for the supply to go down. Increasing cost of production leads for the supply to go down. And if the consumer income increases, that leads for the demand of the good being considered to go up. So in this question, they are talking about a reduction in supply and an increase in demand. Supply decreases means supply curve is shifted to the left, and demand increases means demand curve will be shifted to the right. We will see. But the thing is, in this question, they are not identifying the size of reduction in supply and the size of increase in demand. So it can happen in different ways. We will see the possible ways this can happen. Again, supply decreases and then demand increases. In the first diagram, I will identify a situation where supply decreases, so supply curve is shifted to the right. Supply curve will be shifted to the left, and then demand increases. Therefore, demand curve will be shifted to the right. So what happens is, original demand and supply are intersecting with each other at this point. Price is P1, quantity is Q1. And the new demand and supply are intersecting with each other, D2 and S2 at this point. So price is P2 and then quantity is the same. So in this first diagram, I've identified a situation where demand increases and supply decreases at the same rate. So should identify a same gap between the two demand curves and between the two supply curves. Right. Another way the same thing can happen. What do we mean by the same thing? Supply decreases and demand increases. A relatively higher gap between the two demand curves. And then a smaller gap between the two supply curves. So original demand, original supply. The intersection takes place at this point. Price P1, quantity Q1. The new demand curve and new supply curve are intersecting with each other at this point. Price is P2, quantity is Q2. So price increases, quantity increases. Right? Two different ways of taking place the same thing. In the first diagram, demand and supply are increasing at the same rate. In the second diagram, demand increases and supply decreases at the same rate. In the second diagram, demand increases at a higher rate than the rate of decrease in the supply. Right? So, therefore, in the first diagram, price increases, but the quantity doesn't change. In the second diagram, equilibrium price increases and the quantity is also going up. But under both diagrams, the equilibrium price increases. Quantity doesn't change, increase. We will see another possible way of happening the same. Now, I will identify a relatively higher gap between the two supply curves. Right? And a relatively smaller gap between the two demand curves. Original equilibrium price and quantity. New equilibrium price and quantity. So you could realize here that in this diagram, price increases but the quantity decreases. We drew three diagrams to explain the same. Right? In the first diagram, supply decreases and demand increases at the same rate. In the second diagram that I drew, demand increased at a higher rate than the rate of decrease in the supply. But here, supply decreases at a higher rate than the rate of increase in the demand. Right? So there are different ways of happening the same change in supply and change in demand. But under all the three diagrams we explained, equilibrium price increases from P1 to P2. In the first diagram, equilibrium quantity doesn't change. In the second diagram, equilibrium quantity increased. But in this diagram, equilibrium quantity decreases. So equilibrium quantity can change to the either way, increase, decrease, no change. But under all the three instances, the equilibrium price increases. Equilibrium price increases under all the three instances. So therefore, we'll go back to the question. Both the equilibrium price and the quantity will essentially go up. May go up, but can't say always price and quantity both are definitely going up. Why? According to the three diagrams we drew, under all the three diagrams, price increased. But quantity, in the first diagram did not change, second diagram quantity increased, third diagram quantity decreased. So the first answer cannot be accepted. Second one, equilibrium price increases while equilibrium quantity essentially goes down. Equilibrium price increases while equilibrium quantity essentially goes down. It is true that equilibrium price is essentially going up, but can't say that the quantity is essentially going down. So the second answer cannot be accepted. Third, equilibrium price decreases. No, not at all. Under all the three diagrams we drew, equilibrium price increased. So the third should also be rejected. Fourth, equilibrium price increases. Yes. Equilibrium quantity may increase, decrease, or remain unchanged. That is the answer why we explained that the quantity may change to the either direction, increase, decrease, or no change. Right? So therefore, answer should be the fourth based on the diagram we drew. Right. Next question. Identify the correct statement regarding the given goods. The discussion regarding the given goods and inferior goods what I previously made can be used for this. I told you that when the good being considered is a normal good only, both the substitution effect as well as the income effect are supporting to the law of demand. If the good being considered is a normal good, the substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a good, right? And the income effect is also supporting to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. But when the good being considered is an inferior good, the substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded, while the income effect does not. The income effect goes against the law of demand when the good being considered is an inferior good. Income effect goes against the law of demand when the good being considered is an inferior good. So, just because the good being considered is an inferior good, we cannot say that it does not have a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. the final relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good. The final relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good decides upon the relative size of the substitution effect and the relative size of the income effect if the good being considered is an inferior good. But if the good being considered is a normal good, you cannot have any argument regarding the ultimate relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. Reason: the substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded, while at the same time the income effect is also supporting to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. The issue comes when the good being considered is an inferior good. When the good being considered is an inferior good, when the substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded, the income effect does not support to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. At such a situation, that is when the good being considered is an inferior good, when the good being considered is an inferior good, the ultimate relationship between the price and the quantity demanded depends upon the size of the substitution effect and then the size of the income effect. Even though the substitution effect is supporting to the law of demand, if income effect is more stronger, the income effect overrules the substitution effect and it creates a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. Right? The good being considered is an inferior good. Substitution effect supports to create a negative relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. But the income effect does not. Income effect goes against the law of demand. At such a situation, if income effect is more stronger than the substitution effect, the income effect overrules the substitution effect and creates a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. Creates a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. Such an inferior good only is identified as a given good. Right? Such an inferior good only is identified as a given good. PVC. So I told you a given good is an inferior good. First of all, that good must be an inferior good. In that inferior good, if income effect is more stronger than the substitution effect only, we identify a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded. So what do we mean by an inferior good? We already discussed. An inferior good is a good having a negative relationship between the consumer income and demand. When the consumer income increases, demand for inferior goods go down. And when the consumer income decreases, the demand for inferior goods go up. So, therefore, as there is a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand for an inferior good, the income elasticity is negative in relation to the inferior goods. The income elasticity is negative in relation to the inferior goods. So, therefore, if it is an inferior good, the income elasticity should be negative. And a given good must be an inferior good. So, therefore, if it is a given good, it is an inferior good. Therefore, the income elasticity should be negative. See, income elasticity is positive. With that itself, the answer is wrong. Why? If the good being considered is a given good, it must always be an inferior good. A specific condition of an inferior good only is identified as a given good. What is that specific condition? The income effect of that inferior good should be more stronger than the substitution effect. So, as the good being considered is an inferior good, for that to be a given good, the income elasticity must be negative. So with that, the first answer should be rejected. Second one, income elasticity is negative. True. because it is an inferior good. A given good is definitely an inferior good. So income elasticity is negative. And then income effect of a price change is less powerful than the substitution effect. Wrong. Why? For that inferior good to be a given good, the negative income effect should be more powerful than the substitution effect. So the third answer is also second answer. Income elasticity is negative and income effect of a price change is less powerful than the substitution effect is not cannot be accepted. Third one, price elasticity of demand is negative. No, why? A given good is an exception to the law of demand. So exception to the law of demand means what? There is a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good being considered. So if there is a positive relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of the good, the price elasticity should be positive there. So the third answer says price elasticity is negative, so should be rejected. Fourth, income elasticity is negative. Correct. Why? It is an inferior good. And income effect of a price change is more powerful than the substitution effect. True. Why? Told you that the income effect is negative in relation to an inferior good. A given good is always an inferior good. Therefore, income elasticity is negative. The speciality of a given good is, in that inferior good, the income effect should be more stronger than the substitution effect. So, therefore, answer should be the fourth answer. Income elasticity is negative and income effect of a price change is more powerful than the substitution effect. Right. Question number 12. The diagram below shows the market demand and supply curves of a normal good. Again, what do we mean by a normal good? A normal good is a good having a positive relationship between the income and demand, right? So to say that it is not an exception to the law of demand only, usually this part is added to say that it is a normal good, right? But in this kind of a question, the term normal good does not make any specific application to say that it is complying with the law of demand only. The term normal good is added in the question. PVC. Now, based on the given demand curve, the given supply curve, the equilibrium price and the quantity is decided in the market. Based on the given demand curve and the given supply curve, the P2 price is a lower price than the original equilibrium price of P1. So, whenever the demand curve and the supply curve are intersecting with each other, only the equilibrium price is decided. And then in this question, the new equilibrium quantity is not specifically stated. So, we need to give our attention only on the new equilibrium price. So, if the new supply curve goes like this, the new equilibrium price can be decided as P2. The new equilibrium price can be decided as P2 if the new supply curve goes like this. That is, if supply increased, this can happen. One possible way. Another possible way of decreasing the price from P1 to P2 is if demand decreased to this. If demand decreased, the demand curve will be shifted to the left and that leads for the equilibrium price to go down from P1 to P2. So, therefore, when you are choosing an answer for this, That answer should either be talking about a reduction in the demand, or else it should be talking about an increase in the supply. We learned that if demand decreases, that leads for the equilibrium price to go down. And if supply increases, that leads for the equilibrium price to go down. So your answer should be an answer which is identifying a reason for an increase in supply, or else a reason for a decrease in demand. PVC. First answer, consumer income increased. If consumer income increased, demand increases. Demand curve is shifting to the right. But here, we need to identify a situation where demand goes down. But if consumer income increased, that leads for the demand to go up. Second, the price of a complementary product increased. We already learned. A complementary product is a product which should be used together with the good being considered to get that satisfaction. So if the price of a complementary product increased, what happens is, the demand goes down. Demand goes down means demand curve is shifting to the left, maybe from this to D2. And that is supporting for the equilibrium price to go down from P1 to P2. So the only possible answer out of these given answers is the second answer. The price of a complementary product increased, leading for the demand of the good being considered to go down. The demand curve will be shifted to the left, so equilibrium price decreases. We will analyze the other three answers as well. Cost of production increased. If cost of production increased, supply decreases. Supply decreases means supply curve will be shifting to the left like this. That is not supporting for the price to go down. Next one, imposing a tax on the good. A tax is imposed on the good is also leading for the supply curve to shift to the left. Also leading for the supply curve of the good to shift to the left. So that is also not an answer. 5. Increase in the price of substitute goods. If the price of substitute goods increased, the demand of the good goes up. So the demand curve will be shifted to the right. So therefore, the correct answer out of these 5 answers is the second answer. The price of a complementary product increased. Right. We will move on to the question number 13. Right. Demand equation for a certain product traded in a competitive market is given below. QD equals to 180 minus 9P. Consumer surplus at rupees 10. Right. They've given us the demand curve for a product which is usually sloping downwards, and then we are supposed to calculate the consumer surplus at a specific price. The price is rupees 10. We are supposed to calculate the consumer surplus at rupees 10. What do we mean by the consumer surplus? The consumer surplus refers to the total benefit gained by a consumer. The total benefit gained by a consumer by being able to exchange a product at a lower price than the actual price they are willing to pay for it. Now, if a consumer goes to market to buy something, even expecting to pay some 50 rupees on the product, if the decided market price of this product is 30 rupees at the moment, he's realizing a benefit of 20 rupees by being able to purchase it at rupees 30. So therefore, a consumer surplus will be realized by the consumers who are willing to pay a higher price than the price at which the product is traded in the market. Will only gain a consumer surplus. Right? So, based on this equation, we are supposed to calculate the consumer surplus at rupees 10. Right? You go back to the diagram. So, if this is the demand curve, we are supposed to calculate the consumer surplus at rupees 10. Consumer surplus is always represented through the area above the price paid by the consumer below the demand curve. Actually, this can be applied under any given application. Consumer surplus is always above the area which is above the price paid by the consumer below the demand. I will show it. Right? Consumer surplus should be always above the price paid by the consumer. And then below the demand curve, also it should be gone till the quantity he is actually purchasing. So this triangular area represents the consumer surplus. Right? Consumer surplus is the area of the figure above the price paid by the consumer, below the demand curve, to the quantity he purchases. Right? So in order to calculate this area, you will need the maximum demand price and then the quantity demanded at the given price of rupees 10. Right? The demand equation is given as 180 minus 90. Right. QD equals to 180 minus 9P. So first of all, we'll calculate the quantity demanded at the given price of rupees 10. How? Should apply that price for P in the equation. The quantity demanded at rupees 10 is 90 units. Quantity demanded at rupees 10 is 90 units. Quantity demanded at the price of rupees 10 is 90 units. Right? And then in addition, you will need the maximum demand price. What do we mean by the maximum demand price? The maximum demand price refers to the price at which the quantity demanded is zero. Maximum demand price refers to the price at which the quantity demanded is zero. So, how do we calculate the maximum demand price? Should use the demand equation. Should use the demand equation and again, what do we mean by the maximum demand price? The price at which the QD is zero. So apply zero for QD and simplify the equation. When minus 9P is taken to the other side becomes plus 9P, divide both sides by 9. Maximum demand price is rupees 20. So we calculated the maximum demand price, price at which the quantity demanded is zero is rupees 20. So once you calculate the maximum demand price, you have the price at which you are supposed to calculate the consumer surplus, and then you have the corresponding quantity demanded. As I already told you, this area represents the consumer surplus. This red colored rectangular area shows the consumer surplus. So consumer surplus in a general formula can be calculated by using the formula maximum demand price minus equilibrium price should from the whole thing. We'll write the quantity here, the corresponding quantity demanded. The whole thing should be divided by 2, maximum demand price, the equilibrium price, or the price paid by the consumer. Here actually we are unable to identify an equilibrium price as there is no supply curve. The price paid by the consumer is what we take into consideration here. And then the quantity he purchases, the whole thing should be divided by 2 to get the area of this red colored triangle. So the maximum demand price is rupees 20. The price paid by consumer is rupees 10. Quantity purchased by the consumer is 90. Whole thing divided by 2. So 10 times 90 is 900 divided by 2 is 450 rupees. So this is how we calculate the consumer surplus. We'll go back to the answers. Right, first answer itself shows the correct answer, 450 rupees. So the consumer surplus at this corresponding price is rupees 450. So the first answer itself is the correct answer. Right, we'll move on to the next question. Question number 14. When the price of a packet of butter increases by 25%, quantity demanded for rich people decreases by 10%, whereas quantity demanded of poor people decreases by 30%. Accordingly, butter is, right? We will prepare two schedules. Percentage change in the price, percentage change in the quantity demanded. According to the question, price of butter increases by 25%. Quantity demanded for rich people decreases by 10%. When price increases, if QD decreases, that is complying with the law of demand. So that is going according to the law of demand. But when price increases by 25, the quantity demanded decreases by 10%. Price increases by 25%. Quantity demanded decreases by 10%. The percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price. Percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price. Right? If percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price, we identify that as inelastic price elasticity of demand. If percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price, we identify that as inelastic price elasticity of demand. When the price elasticity of demand is inelastic, the value of price elasticity of demand should be in between 0 and 1. We'll calculate and see. We can use the general formula. Percentage change in the quantity demanded divided by percentage change in the price to calculate the price elasticity of demand. So when price increases by 25%, quantity demanded decreases by 10%. So price elasticity of demand is how much therefore? 10 divided by 5 is 0.4. 10 divided by 25. Price elasticity of demand is 0.4, a number which is in between 0 and 1. Right? Percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price. The price elasticity of demand is giving us a value which is in between 0 and 1. So the product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand for the rich people. The product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand for rich people. The percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in the price. Right. And they are talking about the poor people as well. Right. When price of the product increases by 25%, right, the quantity demanded of poor people decreases by how much? By 30%, right? We'll go back to the right. So price increases by for poor people only this explanation. Price increases by 25% for poor people, but the quantity demanded decreases by 30%. Here the percentage change in the quantity demanded is greater than the percentage change in the price for poor people. So if the percentage change in the quantity demanded is greater than the percentage change in the price, if the percentage change in the quantity demanded is greater than the percentage change in the price, the product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand. The product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand. We can calculate and show it. Price elasticity of demand. Percentage change in the quantity demanded divided by percentage change in the price. When price increases by 25%, QD decreases by 30%. So value of price elasticity of demand is It's 1.2. So price elasticity of demand is 1.2 for rich poor people. 1.2 is a number which is in between 1 and infinity, right? So if the price elasticity of demand is giving you a value which is more than 1, which is in between 1 and infinity, we identify that as an elastic price elasticity of demand. So accordingly, the price elasticity of demand for rich people is inelastic because it was 0.4 as we already calculated, but for poor people it is 1.2 and it is elastic. On that basis, the answer should be, we see, having an inelastic price elasticity of demand for rich people and elastic price elasticity of demand for poor people. So answer number 5 is this is the answer for question number 40. So that is how we can analyze the question. We'll move on to the next question. Next question. Suppose the market for an inferior good is currently at the equilibrium. What effect is there on the demand, equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity if consumer income increases? Right? See here, the specific application in this question is, the question says that the good being considered is an inferior good. The good being considered is an inferior good. We already learned an inferior good is a good having a negative relationship between the consumer income and the demand. When the consumer income increases, the demand goes down. And when the consumer income decreases, the demand goes up. You see? Suppose the market for an inferior good is currently at the equilibrium. It's at the point where the demand curve and supply curve are intersecting with each other. What effect is there on the equilibrium price? Before that, demand and equilibrium quantity, if consumer income increases. If consumer income increases, right. The good being considered is an inferior good. If the good being considered is an inferior good, first of all, the market is at the equilibrium, is at the point where the demand curve and supply curve are intersecting with each other. So we will take equilibrium price as P1, equilibrium quantity as Q1. Right? The product being considered is an inferior good, and the question says that the consumer income increases here. Right? So therefore, if the consumer income increases while the good being considered is an inferior good, the demand should go down and should create a leftward shift of the demand curve of the good being considered. What happens? The new equilibrium price is P2, new equilibrium quantity is Q2, so equilibrium price decreases and then the equilibrium quantity goes down. So, again the question, suppose the market for an inferior good is currently at the equilibrium. What effect is there on the demand? So the demand decreases, demand curve shifted to the left. Equilibrium price decreased and equilibrium quantity decreased if consumer income increases. So therefore, demand decreases, equilibrium price decreases, equilibrium quantity decreases. So answer number 2 is the answer. Right. Next. When the price of rice increases by 20%, demand for bread increased by a certain amount, right? So when the price of one good increases, the demand of the other good goes up. When the price of one good increases, if the demand of the other good increases, those two goods should be substitutes to each other. That is, then only when the price of one good increases, the demand of the good being considered goes up. The question says, when the price of rice increases by 20%, the demand for bread increased by a certain amount. Cross elasticity of demand between rice and bread at this point is +2. The cross elasticity of demand measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded of the good being considered to a certain percentage change in the price of another good. Cross elasticity of demand measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded of the good being considered to a certain percentage change in the price of another good. So when price of another good increases, if the demand of the good being considered increases, that is, if there is a positive relationship between the price of the other good and then the demand of the good being considered, the two goods being considered should be substitutes to each other. Here the cross elasticity is given as +2. Accordingly, the demand for bread should be increased. So in order to do this calculation, we have to calculate the cross elasticity of demand. The cross elasticity of demand can be calculated by using the general formula: percentage change in the quantity demanded of the good being considered. We use QDX to say that it is the quantity demanded of the good being considered, divided by the percentage change in the price of the other good. Percentage change in the quantity demanded of the good being considered, divided by the percentage change in the price of the other good. Cross elasticity of demand is plus 2. And then the price of the price of rice increases by 20%. Price of rice increases by how much? 20%. So with this you can calculate by how much the quantity demanded of the good being considered changes. Right? When you simplify this. The percentage change in the quantity demanded of the good being considered should be 40%. The percentage change in the quantity demanded of the good being considered should be 40% based on this calculation. So therefore, from these 5 answers, any answer which identifies a 40% increase in the quantity demanded should be taken as the answer. We'll see the first answer. It increases from 20 to 40 units. So increasing from 20 to 40 units means it increases by 20. Multiplied by 100, it represents a 100% increase in the quantity. But the correct answer should show a 40% increase in the quantity. So like this, you should evaluate these 5 answers and should see which answer shows a 40% increase in the quantity. So you have to calculate the percentage increase in the quantity for all 5 answers and should see which answer gives you a 40% increase in the quantity. So we will see. So you can easily see this: when it increases from 100 to 140, the amount increased is 40. From 100 multiplied by 100, so it shows a 40% increase in the quantity. So it should calculate everything and should see which answer shows a 40% increase in the quantity. Based on these 5 answers, the only answer shows a 40% increase in the quantity is third answer. Increases from 100 to 140. So the answer number third should be the answer here. A market supply equation for a product sold in a competitive market is given by the equation QS equals to minus 50 plus 10p. If the equilibrium price in the market is rupees 15, the value of producer surplus at equilibrium. Right. The supply equation is given here and the question says that the currently the market is operating at the equilibrium. So whatever the supply curve is, and whatever the demand curve, the currently market should be at the equilibrium. The question says that the equilibrium price is rupees 50. And then we need to know the equilibrium quantity as well to get the producer surplus. Producer surplus is always the area below the price received by the producer. We'll color and identify it. Below the price received by the producer. And above the supply curve to the quantity he purchases. So this triangular area represents the producer surplus. So in order to calculate the producer surplus, we need to know the quantity at this price of rupees 15, and then the minimum supply price is also needed to calculate this triangular area, right? The supply equation is given as QS equals to minus 50 plus 10p. QS equals to minus 50 plus 10p is the supply equation. So we can apply this price of rupees 15 and identify the corresponding quantity supplied. So quantity supplied at this price is how much? 100 units. Also, we need the minimum supply price in order to calculate the producer surplus. What do we mean by the minimum supply price? Minimum supply price is the price at which the quantity supplied becomes zero. Supply equation is minus 50 plus 10p. So the price at which QS is zero, should say zero for QS and simplify the equation. So the minimum supply price is rupees 5. Right. So once you calculate the minimum supply price, so from the equilibrium price, I will use EP to say equilibrium price, you need to deduct the minimum supply price and the gap should be multiplied by the equilibrium quantity. The whole thing should be divided by 2. Equilibrium price 15 rupees, minimum supply price rupees 5, equilibrium quantity 100 units, whole thing divided by 2. So 10 times 100 divided by 2, rupees 500 is the producer surplus. Rupees 500 is the producer surplus. Right. The answer should be third answer, rupees 500. Right. Next. When the price of a certain good increased by 20%, the total consumer expenditure on it increases from rupees 10,000 to 12,000. What can you say about the price elasticity of demand of this good? Right. We will summarize the information given. Price increases by 20%. Price increases by 20%.
As a result, what happens to the quantity demanded increases from 10,000 to 12,000. Right.
We identify a relationship between the change in price and then the change in consumer expenditure. So when price increases, the consumer expenditure increases means the product being considered should have an inelastic price elasticity of demand. When the product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand only, the consumer expenditure changes to the same direction of change in the price. That is, when price of the product increases, if consumer expenditure goes up, and when the price of the product decreases, if consumer expenditure goes down, then only we can say the price and the consumer expenditure are changing to the same direction. So here again the same thing happens. Price increases by 20%, the consumer expenditure increases. But if you look at the percentage increase in the consumer, the quantity demanded increases from 10,000 to 12,000. The quantity demanded. Right, we'll read the question again. When the price of a certain good increased by 20%, the total consumer expenditure, not the quantity demanded, but the total consumer expenditure only increases from 10,000 to 12,000. So price increases, consumer expenditure increases. Price increases, the consumer expenditure increases. Right? So when price increases, if consumer expenditure increases, the product being considered is having an inelastic demand. Right. So by increases by 2,000 from 10,000. So the percentage increase in the consumer expenditure is therefore how much? 20%. When price increases, the consumer expenditure increases. And it increases by the same percentage of increase in the price. Price increases by 20%, the consumer expenditure also goes up by 20%. This kind of a situation can be seen only when the quantity demanded does not change. The quantity demanded does not change after an increase in the price of the good being considered. I will explain this with a small example. So say price increases from 100 to 120. So this is a 20% increase in the price. What they are talking about is also an increase in the price by 20%. If quantity demanded does not change, say it increases, it remains constant at 1000 units. When price is rupees 100, the quantity demanded is 1000 units. When price is rupees 120, the quantity demanded is again 1000 units. The quantity demanded does not change even when the price increases. The quantity demanded does not respond for a change in the price of the good being considered. So, if the quantity demanded does not change even after a change in the price of the good being considered, that product must have a perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand. So we will see the effect on the consumer expenditure here. Previously, the consumer expenditure 100 into 1000 is 100,000. New consumer expenditure, price 120, QD 1000. Consumer expenditure is 120,000. So it increases from 100,000 to 120,000 exactly by 20%. Right? The percentage increase. It increases from 100,000 to 120,000 by 20,000. From 100,000 only it increases. Into 100, the percentage increase is how much? 20%. So when price increases by some percentage, if the quantity demanded does not change at such a situation, the consumer expenditure will also go up by the same percentage. Such a behavior can be observed when the product being considered is having a perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand. The quantity demanded does not change upon a change in the price of the good being considered. So, based on these answers, it should be the second answer, perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand. When the product being considered is having a perfectly inelastic price elasticity of demand only, the consumer expenditure changes by the same percentage of change in the price of the good being considered. Right, next question. Cross elasticity between good X and good Y is plus 2.5. So cross elasticity is measuring the responsiveness of the quantity demanded of the good being considered to a certain percentage change in the price of another good. The cross elasticity of demand measures the responsiveness of the quantity demanded of the good being considered to a certain percentage change in the price of another good. So cross elasticity is positive, means that the price of the other good and the demand of the good being considered are changing to the same direction. So if the cross elasticity of demand is positive, the two goods being considered are substitutes to each other. And if the cross elasticity of demand is positive and more than one, we identify those two goods as two close substitutes. Right? We identify those two goods as two close substitutes. So therefore, here the cross elasticity is positive in one hand. On the other hand, that positive cross elasticity of demand is more than one. It's plus 2.5. It's more than one. So therefore, X and Y are two close substitutes to each other. Why is it? The positive cross elasticity of demand is more than one. Right, we'll move on to the next question. Right, next question. Assume that Dal is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand while televisions are having an elastic price elasticity of demand. What kind of a change in price is required to increase the producer's revenue? What kind of a change in price is required to increase the producer's revenue? Right. We discussed this with the previous question too. A relationship between the change in price and the change in consumer expenditure based on the price elasticity of demand. If the product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand, right? Change in price and change in consumer expenditure. So if price increases, consumer expenditure increases. And if price decreases, the consumer expenditure decreases. So the consumer expenditure changes to the same direction of change in the price when the product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand. Price increases, the consumer expenditure goes up. Price decreases, the consumer expenditure goes down. To the other way, if the product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand, price increases, the consumer expenditure goes down. And price decreases, the consumer expenditure goes up. Like this, there is a negative relationship between the change in price and the change in consumer expenditure if the product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand. So therefore, we'll go back to the question. Assume that dal is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand. So if the product being considered is having an inelastic price elasticity of demand, in order to increase the consumer expenditure, the producer's revenue, in other words, the price of the product should increase. Next part, right? While televisions are having an elastic price elasticity of demand. So when the product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand like this, if producer revenue to go up, what should happen to the price? Price should decrease. If price decreased only, the producer revenue increases if the product being considered is having an elastic price elasticity of demand. So therefore, dal is having an inelastic PED, so price should increase in order to increase the revenue. And televisions are having an elastic PED, so therefore price should decrease in order to increase the revenue. So therefore, answer number 2 is the answer. Price of dal should be increased while price of television should be decreased in order to increase the producer's revenue. Next question. Identify the event which does not create an increase in the consumer surplus of a good traded in a competitive market. So when a production subsidy is offered, the supply curve will be shifted to the right with an amount equal to the subsidy. The equilibrium price decreases and then the equilibrium quantity goes up. So therefore, both the consumer surplus and producer surplus go up after a subsidy offered on the producers of a good. So therefore, that leads for the consumer surplus to go up. But what do they want? Identify the event which does not create, right? The event which does not create an increase in the consumer surplus. So if a subsidy is offered, the consumer surplus increases. Second one, removal of a tax imposed by the government. Right? When a tax is imposed on a certain product, equilibrium price increases and the equilibrium quantity goes down, and therefore the consumer surplus decreases. If that tax is removed, what happens? The consumer surplus will be increased again. So therefore, the second one is also leading for the consumer surplus to increase. Third one, implementing a deficiency payment system by the government. So under a deficiency payment system, what happens is the government implements the minimum price first, and afterwards whatever the quantity supplied by the producer is sold at the price consumers are willing to pay for that quantity. So through that, the consumer will be able to purchase the product at a lower price than what he bought before. So through that, the consumer surplus increases after a deficiency payment system. Right? So therefore, that is also leading for the consumer surplus to go up. Fourth, implementing an excess purchasing system by the government. we will see the effect of an excess purchasing system.
We will discuss this with some numerical presentation. So when the equilibrium price is some 100 rupees, maybe some 500 units are traded in the market. At this situation, if the government implements some 120 rupees as the minimum price at which this product can be traded in the market, maybe the quantity supplied increases to some 600 units.
Quantity supplied increases to some 600 units. But this is something which is expensive to the consumer. Therefore, consumer will respond for this by decreasing the quantity demand. Right? As the question is talking about the consumer surplus,
after the minimum price, the consumer is buying 300 units at 120 each. Previously, the consumer bought 500 units at 100 each. So the whole area was the consumer surplus. But now, consumer is buying 300 units at 120 each, above the price paid by the consumer, below the demand curve to the quantity he purchases. This smaller triangular area is the new consumer surplus.
So therefore, after an excess purchasing system is implemented, the consumer surplus decreases. So what they want us to identify? Identify the event which does not create an increase in the consumer surplus, right? Which does not create an increase in the consumer surplus, right? When an excess purchasing system is implemented, what happens is the consumer surplus decreases, right? So as the consumer surplus decreases, this answer does not lead for
an increase in the consumer surplus. Actually, what happens is the consumer surplus decreases here.
Right? Implementing an excess purchasing system by the government leads for the consumer surplus to go down. Right.
Right, we'll move on to the next.
Price elasticity of demand of a certain good is 2.5 and the price elasticity of supply is 0.8. If the government imposes a unit tax on the sellers of this good.
So according to this question, price elasticity of demand is 2.5. PED is anyway minus and it is 2.5. Right, price elasticity of supply is 0.8. Right, price elasticity of demand is 2.5 means it is a number which is in between 1 and infinity. It is a number which is in between 1 and infinity. So therefore, the price elasticity of demand is elastic. But price elasticity of supply is 0.8 means it is a number which is in between 0 and 1. So this product is having an inelastic price elasticity of supply. Right? Price elasticity of demand is elastic and then price elasticity of supply is inelastic. So the price elasticity of supply is less than the price elasticity of demand.
Whenever the price elasticity of supply is less than the price elasticity of demand, whenever the price elasticity of supply is less than the price elasticity of demand, a greater part of the tax is borne by the producer. We can explain it through a diagram.
An inelastic supply curve always starts from the quantity axis. And a tax leads for a leftward shift of the supply curve of the good being considered. And an elastic demand curve is more slanted towards the quantity axis. Original equilibrium price and quantity. Right? And then new equilibrium price and quantity. Equilibrium price increases, equilibrium quantity decreases. The area which shows the increase in price shows the burden on the consumer.
So the red colored rectangle shows the tax burden on the consumer.
But then the producer who received a price of P2 should pay the gap between the two supply curves to the government.
The gap between the two supply curves is gone to the government as the tax per unit.
So what retains with the producer after the tax is only P3.
So price received by the producer after the tax is P3.
So previously he received P1 price, after the tax he is receiving only P3. So this whole rectangle shows the tax burden on the producer.
So you can see that the green colored rectangle is bigger in area than the red colored rectangle. So the tax burden on the producer is definitely greater than the tax burden on the consumer. So therefore, whenever the price elasticity of supply is less than the price elasticity of demand, the greater part of the tax is borne by the producer. So we'll go back to the answers. A greater part of the tax is borne by the seller. So therefore, answer should be the third answer for the question number 20. Right. Right, next question. Demand and supply equations of a certain good traded in a competitive market are given below. If the government imposes a guaranteed price of rupees 30 on this product and implements a deficiency payment system, the market price of the product after implementing the deficiency payment system is.
So, when the government implements a deficiency payment system, what happens is, a minimum price should be a price which is greater than the equilibrium price. The question says that a minimum price of rupees 30 is implemented. So the minimum price imposed on this product is rupees 30. The quantity supplied by the producer at this price is should calculate by using the supply equation. Supply equation is given as minus 120 plus 10p, right? Supply equation is minus 120 plus 10p. Should calculate the quantity supplied at the price of rupees 30. So should say 30 for the price. So the quantity supplied at this price of rupees 30 is 180 units.
So under a deficiency payment system, what happens is, first of all, the government implements the guaranteed price, and afterwards the producer supplies some specific quantity. The government allows the producer to sell that total quantity at the price consumer is prepared to pay for that quantity in the market.
So how do you find out the price consumer is willing to pay for a quantity of 180 units? Should go along with 180 units to the demand curve and should find out that corresponding price. Right. How do we do this? Right. Should go to the demand equation QD equals to 240 minus 5P. Right. 240 minus 5P. Right, he should find out the price consumer is willing to pay for a quantity of 180 units. So instead of QD, we put 180. Why? Need to see the price consumer is prepared to pay for a quantity of 180 units. So therefore, 5P is equal to 240 minus 180, so it is 60 units. P is equal to 12, so therefore price consumer is willing to pay for a quantity of 180 is 12 rupees. So the government allows the producer to trade this product in the market at the price of rupees 12. The question is expecting you to calculate the price at which the product is traded in the market after implementing the deficiency payment system. So after implementing the deficiency payment system, the guaranteed price of rupees 30, producer is coming up with a supply of 180 units and that quantity is traded in the market at the price of rupees 12. So therefore, the market price is rupees 12. The market price is rupees 12. Right. We'll move on to the next. Right. Next question. Demand and supply schedules before and after imposing a unit tax on producers of a good is given below. Right, the tax per unit and the new equilibrium price after the tax respectively are PVC. So they've given us the supply schedule before tax and then the supply schedule after tax. The producer expected to supply 200 units to the market before the tax is imposed is how much? 50 rupees. Producer expected the price of rupees 50 to supply 200 units before the tax is imposed. But after the tax is imposed, to supply the same 200 units, the producer is expecting how much? 70 rupees. He previously expected 50 rupees to supply 200 units, but to supply the same 200 units after the tax is, he is expecting 70 rupees. So he is expecting 20 rupees more than the price he expected before, means what? The tax per unit is rupees 20. He is expecting 20 rupees more than the price he expected before. So therefore, the tax per unit is rupees 20. And then you should compare the demand schedule and then the supply schedule after tax to get the new equilibrium price and quantity. When the price is 50, QD is 800, QVC is 0. They are not matching with each other. Like that, you have to find out a price where QD and QVC are equal to each other. At rupees 90, QD is 400, the QVC is also 400. Therefore, this is the price at which the quantity demanded and quantity supplied are equal to each other. At rupees 90, quantity demanded is, at rupees 90, QD is 400, QVC is also 400. Therefore, new equilibrium price is rupees 90
and the tax per unit is rupees 20. So the answer number one is the answer. Right. We'll move on to the next question. Right. Suppose a certain product is not domestically produced and any quantity can be imported at a price of rupees 60. Demand equation for this product is QD equals to 800 minus 5P. If the government imposes an import duty of rupees 20 on this product, the change in consumer surplus is. So we will try to present it through a graph. When a country is importing a certain product at the decided international market price, the import supply curve starts from that respective price and is moving parallel to the quantity axis to say that any amount of this product can be imported at the price of rupees 60. So should find out the corresponding quantity the consumer is willing to buy at this respective price. How do you do that? The demand equation is given as QD equals to 800 minus 5P. Right? The demand equation is given as QD equals to 800 minus 5P. At the price of rupees 60, the quantity the consumer is willing to buy, 5 times 60 is 300. So the consumer is willing to buy 500 units at the price of rupees 60. Right? So consumer is buying 500 units at the price of rupees 60 means what? The whole area represents the consumer surplus under this situation. Consumer is buying 500 units at the price of rupees 60. But when the government imposes an import duty of rupees 20 on this product, what happens is, right? The new import supply curve will start from rupees 80. Why is it? Tax is rupees 20, no? The import supply curve will be shifted to the left with an amount equal to the tax. Right? Import supply curve will be shifted to the left with an amount equal to the tax. So should find out the quantity the consumer is willing to buy at this respective price. Again, the demand equation is QD equals to 800 minus 5P. If the price is rupees 80, the quantity demanded will be 400 units. So now the consumer is buying only 400 units at the price of rupees 80. So the new consumer surplus will be only this much. Right. So the question is asking us to identify the change in consumer surplus. We'll calculate. So we need the maximum demand price in order to calculate the consumer surplus. Maximum demand price is the price at which the QD is zero. So therefore, maximum demand price is how much? $160. This is the maximum demand price, that is $160. So we'll calculate the consumer surplus before tax and the after tax.
at the original situation, this whole green colored triangle is the consumer surplus. Therefore, 160 minus 60 multiplied by 500 divided by 2. Consumer surplus before imposing the tax import duty is 25,000 rupees. But after imposing the tax, consumer is buying 400 units at 80 each. Therefore, the consumer surplus is 16,000 rupees. So the change in consumer surplus is 9,000.
Right, so therefore this is how we can identify the change in consumer surplus due to the imposing of import duty. So it decreases by, previously it was 25,000, now it is 16,000, so it decreases by 9,000 rupees. So therefore the answer should be the consumer surplus decreases by 9,000. So we discussed 25 questions based on the second lesson and in the third lesson of the syllabus. So with this we tried to identify some important applications of the two lessons. Think you all understood the explanation we made up to this point. So we will meet with another seminar covering up another lesson. So think you understood the explanation we made up to this point. So we will meet with a new topic. So thank you very much for the Bank of Ceylon for giving me the opportunity to join with this social responsibility project. Thank you.